In this lesson, we will see the Webpack configurations that we will use for all the upcoming chapters in this course. Moving to the editor, we will use these configurations to start the TypeScript compiler. I'll close the terminal for now. Let us understand these configurations which we have in our webpack.config.js file. Here, the entry option is where the Webpack looks to start building the bundle. The DevTool option tells Webpack that source maps should be created in line with the final bundle that it produces. Providing the mode configuration option tells Webpack how to use its built-in optimization accordingly. Its value can be development, production, or none. Next is the module option, which configures the TS loader to run the TypeScript compiler for us. It generates the JavaScript output that is added to the final bundle and sent to the browser. The resolve property here tells Webpack which files it should use for module resolution. Output specifies the name of the bundle file Webpack will produce. This is the name of the file that will be sent to the browser, bundle.js for us. The last section here is the configuration to use Webpack with the development server to provide live reloading. So running the npm start will invoke the Webpack with its configuration file. TSLoader will compile the TypeScript. Webpack will bundle the output JavaScript and start the development server. And the browser will now use bundle.js file generated using Webpack. So now, I no longer need this JS folder and the files in here. So I'll delete them. And then in my index.html file, I'll update the script reference to bundle.js. Now, by default, the Webpack dev server won't actually write a file to the disk named bundle.js. It will be created in the memory and served to the browser. So we won't see it show up as a new file in the project. Let's see this in action. In the terminal, here I have my server running. Moving to the browser, I've opened my network tab in the developers tool here. And now when I refresh this page, you can see bundle.js is loaded here. On hitting the start game button, I get the message that was expected. Now we will use this way to compile the code and serve it to the browser. So this was all about our first chapter on setting up TypeScript and configuring the project. Summarizing what we just learned in this chapter, we installed all the dependencies, npm, TypeScript, Webpack, and other modules. We compiled the TypeScript file from the terminal. We also configured the TypeScript configuration file tsconfig.json, the default one at the root, as well as the inherited one. Then we checked how we can use Webpack built-in development server to compile our TypeScript code. Let us now jump to our next chapter and see the built-in types in TypeScript, how they make the coding efficient and help in checking errors. See you there.